Yes, class 9. Silence, please. Open up your books. As today, we are going to start with the poem, No Men Are Foreign. Okay? So, as the poem indicates, no men are foreign. It means that this poem is related with all the people of this country only. No. Of the entire world. What does this title displays you? Yes, very good. Okay, so this title, it you can say it delivers the feeling of universal brotherhood. Universal brotherhood, that we people have created boundaries, we have created territories, we have separated ourselves from others. But actually, was it right? Since you can say since prehistoric times, okay, when the human being they started living in groups or in tribes or forming a community, what was their wish? To invade others, to extend their territories they were trying. Okay, and in this, you can say, in this race of invading the territories, they are forgetting the basic, you can say, the basic commonality which is prevailing among all the people of this world, that actually we are not separate from each other. Are we separate from each other? No. We are actually not separate from each other. We share same things, okay? We share the same, we enjoy the same bounties of nature. Bounties of nature, see. Bounties of nature. What is the meaning of bounties of nature? Gifts of nature. Okay, what are the gifts of nature? In the form of resources. It can be sunlight. It can be air. Water. Okay, minerals. And whatever the other things. According to their distribution, we are enjoying these bounties of nature. Has nature discriminated? No. Then why we human beings are? Why we are discriminating among ourselves? What is the reason behind it? Okay? Why we people are creating boundaries? Well, the poet is saying that we have created the boundaries, but suppose a boundary is created or a territory is separated or demarcated from the other territory. So when the sun shines, is he following that rule? That I am the son of this country, not of that country? He is universally shedding its light upon both the countries without any kind of discrimination. So what it means that nature is not at all discriminating among people. And if nature is not discriminating among people, then why we human beings? Hasn't this nature this nature is always teaching us the lesson that we need not to discriminate ourselves with? Okay, why we are discriminating? Isn't it ironical also that we are creating boundaries, but something is there? Attendance? Count and dear tell. That something is there which is always reminding us, no, whatever you are doing is of not any use. It is just your futile effort. What you are doing is just, you can say, useless. There is no need. Okay? And now you know that this concept, it has, you can say, it was not so old, but you can say that it is somewhat 100 to 80 years old only, that when this word is considered to be as unit. Earlier, nobody has put this concept forward. Okay? That we have to, in order to save this planet, what we need to think as a unit. We should not think that this is my earth, this is their country, or this is the part of their country. And ultimately what will happen? They will fight with each other. No, actually this is not the reality. We need to save this earth as a unit. We should not think that I'm a part of this country and I'm part of the other country. But no, of course, we are actually the part of this world only. if one part is affected, ultimately the other parts also will have to see its consequences. Suppose there is a fire in one country at a, you can say, at a large level. So what will happen? Isn't its effects or smoke, it will not affect the adjoining areas, whether they belong to the other country? They will affect, they will ultimately face the consequences. Okay, suppose a forest is shared between territories of two countries, though there is a demarcation, okay, territorial demarcation they have created both the countries. But if a fire is in one part, it will spread to the other part, right? So ultimately, the poet is telling us that we should not do any kind of discrimination. We should not practice any kind of discrimination among the people because it is useless. We follow the same physiognomy. Okay, what is the meaning of physiognomy? Physical structure, right? We share the same physiognomy. Physiognomy means physical structure. Okay, we share the same physiognomy, that is physical structure. Physical structures, we have the same type of hands, same number of fingers, same eyes, same type, okay, same function they are performing of seeing the world, right? Then ultimately they open up, they close when we are feeling asleep. If we are putting hard labor and getting the result to achieve something, the same is there for the other people of other countries also. Isn't it there that we people are putting in hard labor and we are getting the result, and the people of the other country, they are not getting? The same rules of life are being followed, then how we are different? How we are different? It is here only in our minds, okay, that we have created these kind of differences. As we have created these kind of differences, and it is because of this reason that people are suffering from this kind of mentality that we are different. Actually, we are not different. We are Earthians, means inhabitants of this earth only. Okay, we should consider ourselves to be the inhabitants or to be the natives of this, you can say, this earth only. But rather than considering ourselves to be separate units, okay, separate units of this earth only, no, it's not like that. And there is a responsibility of ourselves to respect the integrity of this planet also. And we should put our efforts in order to respect as well as maintain this, you can say, though there is diversity, but still there is unity. If one part is affected, it will naturally affect the other parts also. Suppose a world war is there, or fight is there between two countries. So now what will be the result of it? The whole world will be affected, okay? Because this country may be responsible for transportation of many resources. Okay, so business will be affected. Moreover, the smoke, because of arms and ammunition, they are, you can say, affecting the atmosphere of this entire world. So how? Then how we are separate? We are actually not separate from each other. It is only this kind of discrimination that we have made is actually separating us. And this we need to remember, that we are not separate from each other. The poet is delivering us the message that we should follow the policy of universal brotherhood. So which policy we should follow? We should follow the, yes, that we should follow the policy of universal brotherhood. Actually, it means that we are not at all different from ourselves. It is only we people who have created these kind of boundaries. Okay, it is we people who have tried to separate ourselves from other countries. But actually, what is there? Nature has never demarcated us. Okay, nature has never separated us. Okay, it is only we who are following these rules, and we should try to forget this. And ultimately, what we should? We should follow the policy of universal brotherhood, that we are a part of this earth only, and we are a part of this, you can say, one unit that is called as our planet. Okay. So this is just the main thing that the poet he wants to deliver to us, right? So heaven, you got what the poet want to deliver to us? Yes. Can you tell me what he wants to tell? Huh? Universal brotherhood, right? Okay, so he is delivering the message. So let us start from what is given in the box. Have you ever thought of some people as strange or other countries as foreign? Yes, we of course, that is the first thing that comes to our mind. When we see a native of other country, we consider him as foreigner. Okay, we consider that he is a foreigner. It means foreigner means from other country, from other place. Okay, it means that he is not sharing the same territory. Okay, we have many ways of thinking of other people as different from us as them. Yes, there are many ways, okay, in which we look themselves as different from us. How they are different from us? First of all, color of skin, clothes, culture, way of speaking, language, okay, traditions, okay, followed by them, nationality, right? So number of ways. We immediately, our mind clicks to all the type of differences that exist between us and that person who has come from other country. Okay, it means we are trying to formulate the differences. We are trying to locate as well as extract the differences which we are suffering from, which we shall, you can say, how we are different from the other ones, right? So we have many ways of thinking about it. They may belong to a different country or speak a different language. In this poem, however, the poet reminds us of the many ways in which we all are same, for we are all human. So this, through this poem, as I have told you, that the poet is reminding us that how we are same, okay, and why we are considering ourselves as different. It is not actually the reality, okay. So let us start with the poem. First paragraph is, remember, no men are strange, no countries foreign. So the first line of this poem, it gives the message that we should remember this fact that no men are strange. Okay, no men are strange means no one is unknown to us. We actually know each other, for we follow the same rules of life. We live a same type of life. No men are strange and no countries foreign. And we should also not consider any country as foreigner. Okay, but actually we are not different from each other. What actually we are? We are similar. We are of the same type. Beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. So here the poet is implying the significance of uniforms. What is the function of uniform? Why a uniform is always made? For an army, there is a uniform. In school, a uniform. Why there is a concept? There is a concept of uniform in the school. Very good. This is one of the main thing. Okay. That, first of all, it is also a source of avoiding distraction. On the basis of clothing, that people will otherwise, what they will do, the students will otherwise, they will look down upon others, or they will think that he is wearing or she is wearing the best clothes, so this is the best child. Actually, what it implies, it is meant for the purpose that there is not any kind of discrimination. Okay, that we all are same. Okay, moreover, it is also a means of developing a sense of discipline, to show oneness, that we belong to this institution. Okay, this is what, okay, to give a sense of oneness, that we belong to this institution. Similarly, other institutions, they have their different kind of uniforms. Okay, and now afterwards, why a uniform is made for a soldier or for an army? The uniform is made for a soldier or an army to, in order to, yes, in order to highlight their nationality, so that they can be demarcated, they can be separated from the soldiers of other countries. So whenever there is a fight, no two soldiers on both the sides, they have the same uniform. Okay, but have you ever thought that when two soldiers, they are fighting with each other, they know each other? No. They have any personal grudges? Why they are fighting? For their nation. They are fighting only for nation only. Okay, so it is their feeling of, you can say, nationality. Okay, to serve their country, for which they are sacrificing their own love, their own lives. But actually, if we take it from the other perspective of humanity, that they don't have any grudges, still they are fighting with each other. Okay, so if they will try to develop peace, sense of peace, maybe the soldiers will not fight with each other and there will be peace. If we look into through different perspective. Okay, so here the poet is highlighting the importance of uniforms, that beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. That what is the function of uniforms? To separate people from others. But what is there under all uniforms? Single body breathes. Single body breathes means that one body is there, which is same, whether the soldier is of this country or he is of that of other country. They are altogether same. So don't you think that here the role of uniforms is ironical in nature? Role of uniforms is ironical in nature, or you can say uniforms are ironical in nature. How they are ironical? What is irony? What is said, or what is said, it is different from what actually it is. Uniforms are made in order to separate people from other countries. They are meant to demarcate themselves from other territories. But actually, is it serving that purpose? No, only outside the body it is serving this purpose. Inside, what is there? That we all are same. Okay, inside we all are same. Then why this kind of discrimination is there? Okay. A single body breathes like ours. The land our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. So the poet is saying like we have the land where we walk upon. Okay. The similar type of what it is there, the similar type of land is there on which they walk, other people also walk upon. Okay, other people also walk upon. Is earth like this in which we all shall lie? And similarly, after dying, after death, what will happen? We all will lie in this earth, whether there will be different kind of rituals, rites. Okay. Some people, they bury their dead. Some people, they cremate, burn their dead. It is, they are different. But this doesn't mean that we are separate from each other. Ultimately, the universal rules are same for all of life. Then how we are different from each other? Yes, it is only the thinking, okay, that we have developed, that we are different from each other. But actually, what is there? We are not different from each other. We are same. Okay, we are not different from each other. So this is what the poet is saying, like ours, the land our brothers walk upon. So he has firstly used the word brothers. So what he is saying, like we are walking upon the land. So similarly, what is there? That they are also walking upon the same type of land, the earth. Okay, which is not at all different from each other. We are not separated from each other. And is earth like this in which we all shall lie? And this is the earth only in which we have immersed out, we have taken birth upon. And ultimately, with the passage of time, after living our lives, what will happen? That we will be a part of this earth only. We will sleep there forever. Although there are different ways of doing this. Okay, so here again I am highlighting the thing that uniforms are ironical in nature. Okay, that uniforms are ironical in nature. People have made uniforms in order to look different, but actually what is there? They all are same. Okay, they all are same. See the rhyme scheme. Foreign A breathes B upon C and lie D. A, B, C, D means no rhyme scheme is there. So next line is, they too aware of sun and air and water. Yes. They too are aware of sun, air and water. What it means that they too are enjoying the bounties of nature. They too are enjoying the, you can say, all the resources of nature. Nature is never discriminating. Sun is never saying that I will give more light to this part of earth because this is my favorite. Okay, it's not at all partial. It is, you can say, displaying all the resources in a uniform manner without any kind of discrimination. That how we can say that we are different? If nature is not discriminating, why should we? Yes, next line is a very long description, and fed by peaceful harvest, by war's long winter star. Okay, so this we will continue tomorrow as the time is not allowing, right? So if you have any doubts till now, you can ask me.